Good morning, students. Today I am going to explain about the political history of Golconda Qutb Shahis in part 2. In part 1 we shall discuss about the rulers of the Golconda kingdom, like Muhammad Quli and Jamshed and Ibrahim Qutb Shah. These three rulers information can be discussed in previous video. And today the remaining rulers of Golconda kingdom, in that the Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah. The Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah's time period is, the chronology of Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah is 1582-1612 is the chronology time period of the Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah. Who is Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah? He was the son of Ibrahim Qutb Shah. Ibrahim Qutb Shah died in young age, just 48 years he died. When the Ibrahim Qutb Shah died, he have only 15 years, just 15 years. At the age of 15 years, the Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah ascended the throne of Golconda kingdom, just 15 years. But he played a remarkable role, and he occupied a remarkable place in the history of Golconda Qutb Shahis. Why? Because he built a number of famous and magnificent constructions, and also the Hyderabad city, now the capital of Telangana, the Hyderabad city built by the Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah. I mentioned here, he built Hyderabad city and Charminar. The Charminar is the symbol of Hyderabad city. Charminar is the symbol of tourism of the Hyderabad city. And Jama Masjid and Chandra Mahal are built by the Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah. He was an able administrator, because the credit goes to his Peshwa. Who is his Peshwa? Mir Momin Asrabadi. Mir Momin Asrabadi was a able Mir Jumla. It means Prime Minister of Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah. He introduced so many reforms, and he was implemented so many public welfare schemes in the dynasty of the Golconda kingdom. That's why his master Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah raised a great able administrator in the history of Golconda Qutb Shahis. And Muhammad Quli Qutb Shah maintained a friendly relations with Mughal rulers, especially Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah was the contemporary of the great Mughal Empire Akbar. He maintained a friendly relations with Akbar King, and he captured and he invaded the neighboring states of Golconda Kingdom. Especially, he invaded an Vijayanagara regions and occupied Vijayanagaran territories. In that, he captured Karnool, Gutti, Udayagiri, Gandikota, and Penugonda. These all regions are Vijayanagaran territories. He invaded on Vijayanagara territories and occupied these regions. During his time, the European companies entered in Andhra Desh. During his time, the European companies entered in Andhra Desh. He gives permission to trading in this region, and also he was a great patron of scholars. Scholars nothing but poets. Especially he patronized Telugu poets. A number of Telugu poets were patronized by Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. And Telugu language also patrons by the Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. At the year of 1612, he was died. This is a brief information about Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah. Now I am going to explain about the after ruler Sultan Muhammad Qutub Shah. Who is that Sultan Muhammad Qutub Shah? What is his time? 1612 to 1626. There is no significance in the history of Qutub Shahis, but he laid the foundation of Makkah Masjid. This was a great event in the history of Sultan Muhammad Qutub Shah. Actually, Muhammad Qutub Shah was no sons. His daughter, husband, he was the nephew of Muhammad Quli Qutub Shah, who is Sultan Muhammad. Now, the Makkah Masjid was laid the foundation by the Sultan Muhammad in the year of 1617. It was completed by 1687 by the Aurangzeb. It is Makkah Masjid construction was completed by Aurangzeb, but it was laid foundation by Sultan Muhammad. And next ruler, Abdullah Qutub Shah. Abdullah Qutub Shah's time period is 1226 to 72. 1226 to 72. Who is he? He was the son of Sultan Muhammad. Who is he? He was the son of Sultan Muhammad. And he lived a life of pleasure and else. He lived the life of pleasure and else. During his period, the Mughal invades are started on the Golconda Kingdom. That's why, by the protection of his kingdom, he paid heavy indemnity to the Mughals. He paid heavy indemnity is to the Mughals. So this is a brief information about Abdullah Qutub Shah. And now final ruler of Golconda dynasty is Abdullah Hasan Tanisha. Abdullah Asan, Tanisha. Its time period is 1670 to 87. 1670 to 87. He was the last ruler of the Qutb Shahis. He was the last ruler of Golconda Kingdom, but he was an able ruler and a good administrator. He followed a religious tolerance in this region. He worked always to the protection of kingdom and protection of the life of the people. He tried always and also followed religious tolerance in this region. Actually, he belongs to Muslim community, but he was encouraged the Telugu people, and also he appointed a clever Telugu ministers like Akkanna Madanna, a great brothers. They were very clever and they were able administrators. By receive of their knowledge, he appointed as Mir Jumlas of Golconda Kingdom. This was not like by other Muslims. During the year of 1684, Akkanna Madanna was murdered by the Muslim communities, and Aurangzeb, during his time, Aurangzeb also invades on Golconda fort. Especially Abdullah Fani, itadu oka drohi, he was open the doors of Golconda fort. The Mughal army enter of the Golconda fort. One person was fight against the Mughal army in single hand, Abdullah Razak. So at the end, during the year of 1687, Golconda fort was captured by Mughal army, and also Abdullah Hasan, he was known as Tanisha, he was also captured by Mughal army and sent to Bidar, and after that he was sent to Daulatabad fort. In the year of 1699, he was died at fort of Daulatabad. And Telangana region also merged in the court of Mughals. This was a brief information about Abul Hasan Tanisha. Okay students, tomorrow we shall discuss about the administration of the Golconda Qutb Shahis.